Members of the SANDF have been deployed all over the country to assist police in reinforcing strict lockdown regulations. This comes at the expense of the taxpayers, as it will cost nearly 650 million rand. For more about that deployment, we're joined via Skype by Sol Plaatje University's Head of Heritage Studies, Dr. Garth Benneyworth. Garth, thank you so much for joining us this morning. President Cyril Ramaphosa, in giving his instructions to the SANDF, said the security forces must save lives, not violate rights, and on all accounts are expected to be on duty until deep into June. Is as a total number of 641 million rand. What does that number say to you?
Well, what is the alternative? I mean, if we look at the alternative and take Italy as a case study, and we look at the number of lives that are actually being lost through coronavirus or through the results from it, the alternative is far worse. So we spend 640 million rand, 700 million rand, but if we lose 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, a million of our population, I think that's money well spent, actually. It's not possible for the police services and other security services to actually contain the situation. The military is required, although it's a very, very difficult relationship between civilian society and the military.
Now, in terms of the numbers, we're looking at the authorized employment of 2,820 members of the SANDF for a, quote, service of cooperation. Now, for those laymen who have never lived in a time in South Africa where they've seen members of the army on the streets, what does a service of cooperation mean to you?
Well, there's a number of ways. I mean, one looks at it from a visual sense. You see soldiers on the street, and there's generally sort of a civilian reaction to that, which is not always positive. On the other hand, the military can be used to actually provide essential services, for example, transporting water, transporting food, and providing general security that, in other words, the resources are currently stretched to provide.
And then on top of that, probably even more so importantly, depending on the disaster that you're dealing with, in this case a health one, there's the SA Military Health Service that's now also called up the reserve force doctors. That's going to become more and more important over the coming weeks, isn't it?
Correct. I mean, the military health services are very highly trained in dealing with sort of situations of pandemics such as this. So they would be an essential service that would in fact supplement the already stretched state resources that we have in this country. I mean, our economy is in serious trouble. Yes, it's going to take an enormous hit from this three-week shutdown. If it even stays as 3 weeks, if we look at Italy's case, it could even go on longer. So therefore, the state resources need to be mobilized and deployed as rapidly as possible, and that includes the military.
Now, we had a little bit of a litmus test around this kind of thing, but perhaps in a different set of circumstances, when members of the SANDF were sent in to try and settle down gang violence on the Cape Flats. And there was a mixed reaction to that deployment. Many residents saying it helped them feel a bit safer, others saying that it was too heavy-handed and it was quite triggering. What do you think we could learn from that deployment on the Cape Flats that happened just last year?
Well, granted, the circumstances are very different. I mean, we face a global pandemic in this particular instance. Gang violence on the Western Cape has a long history. Also, too, the deployment of soldiers into the townships in this country's past has also a rather unpleasant memory. So there is that. But on the other hand, we are faced with a crisis of unprecedented proportions. Therefore, the resources of the state need to be mobilized, and that includes the army. And unfortunate as it may appear visually, it is actually very necessary. If we look at the other cases that are going on in the world, such as Italy, I mean, countries like Italy and Spain have deployed their military in supporting the civilian resources. Are we any different? Is it money well spent? Of course it is. I mean, the alternative is too worse to consider.
Now, indeed. Now, the president has said security forces must save lives and not violate rights. He repeatedly said that the soldiers going out to do their duty would not be entering hostile territory. I suppose the question will be, how long will that idea continue for as we head ever deeper into this very serious lockdown?
Well, I mean, the doctrines are different. So the military is trained under a certain doctrine. Police services are trained under a different doctrine. So it's granted, you know, it's never a desirable situation to have the military deployed into a civilian area. That is, you know, that is undesirable. It has its consequences too. However, the military is disciplined, and it is under a command and control structure. And it's difficult to predict where this may go, but on the other hand, it needs to go in this direction, which it currently is doing. I mean, we hear about Alexandra where people are openly resisting the lockdown. I mean, we saw this in the panic buying a couple of days before. So who knows where the extent of coronavirus has already penetrated South African society and even our neighboring states as well. We need to do this, and we need to do this as efficiently and as effectively as possible.
Okay, thank you so much for that insight. Dr. Garth Benneyworth is with Sol Plaatje University. Thank you so much for joining us via Skype this morning.